Everybody, it's Evicta. It's time to continue our adventures here in the Binding of Isaac Evicta Repentance series. And today we've got ourselves one more run on Judas. I realized yesterday that we hadn't actually unlocked the B-side or the tainted side of Judas yet. Even though we've beaten Dogma and the Beast on Judas, we still need to unlock that because I hear that the tainted version of Judas is really awesome. So that's what we're going to do today. Also, shout out to you guys and gals out there in the mosh pit who rallied behind the call on the community post about the like streak actually dangerously coming close to being ended. But you all did it. It did push it forward. So you see the new like streak counter goal has been updated down below, or the counter, I should say. So thank you all very much for making that possible. Here's your meme of the day brought to you this time around by someone whose name I'm not even going to try to pronounce because it's just a bunch of random letters and numbers. But the top thread was shout out to the man who got convicted to put the music on Bandcamp. And yes, indeed, that is not really a meme, but it's almost like just a shout out to my good friend Ziggy D. Those of you who play Path of Exile are going to be very familiar with that name. And it was indeed Ziggy who told me about Bandcamp. So long ago, 4 years ago. So thank you very much to Ziggy D. Go check him out. He's a great guy. I'm a big fan of Ziggy D. Today's going to be November Hotel, Foxtrot Lima, Lima X-Ray Delta Romeo. We've got Judas, and that's all you need to know. Starting with the Book of Belial here. So what we're going to do is we're going to just go straight to Dogma. We don't have to worry about beating Dogma or even the Beast, of course, because all we need to do is just unlock Judas. But in order for us to do that, we have to drop a trinket inside of the item room to make sure that we get the cracked key to spawn, or the red key to spawn, whatever, cracked key, whatever it is. And then that way, of course, we can access the secret room, which allows us to get the B-side Judas. So now on the subject of planetariums here, a good point was brought up. I think I talked about this yesterday, but I don't remember if I did it on stream or not, or if it was on the video, but I'm just going to reiterate. If you're going for Dogma, you might as well go for a planetarium anyway. You don't have to skip all of the rooms, obviously, but I think that there is some merit to doing so because if you end up going for Dogma, you're going to go back through every single item room that you've skipped, right, during the ascent, back through the crawl space and whatnot. So it makes sense that you try to get at least one or two item rooms just skipped because, you know, planetariums have been pretty bad for us lately, except for I think Pluto was the one that was decent, but all the other planetariums were pretty darn bad. Although I did somehow spawn a planetarium naturally with a 1% chance the other day on stream, which was unbelievable. I like going to the first item room anyway, and yep, there's that. Demon baby, no thank you. Well, no. Sorry, demon baby, not sorry. Secret room's probably here. Humbling bundle wouldn't be too bad if we can get enough money for it. That's not going to be enough money for it, unfortunately. But yeah, all you have to do to get a planetarium, or at least theoretically anyway, is to just not go into the item rooms at all. You can't unlock them, can't do anything. Gotta be careful against the turtlings, actually. They're a little bit wonky. If you stay pressed up against the wall, you should be okay. What you don't want them is sliding all the way, basically what you don't want them to do is slide all over the room, like, separately, and then they start charging you. You don't want to cross paths with both of them at the same time, let's put it that way. Take down the dips here. Divorce papers, which is going to give us the tears up, and also an empty heart container. And, yeah, let's go back into that library, see if we can get the bookworm transformation, which I think is still good, ? Let's go see. Satanic Bible also wouldn't be too bad if we can get one. We don't get Satanic Bible, but we do get the Book of Revelations, which will give us some orbitals. And a soul heart. We also get the Book of Shadows, which is not bad either. I think, though, for our purposes of this run, we're going to go ahead and take the Book of Revelations just because, it is HP. Yes, the Book of Belial is very good, especially since you can stack it on itself now with Judas, but at the end of the day, I'd rather have more HP than I know what to do with. All right, so Curse of the Lost, here we go. Now we have a chance to reject Stanley and go for an Angel Deal run. And honestly, I think Angel Deals are slowly being the meta, kind of. It seems like I see a lot more people going for them. And it makes sense, right? Like, I mean, it's so easy to lose HP in repentance nowadays that, you want to go almost more defensive, you know, and repentance definitely succeeded in changing the meta in terms of everything's the best offense is still the best defense, but, you know, maybe sometimes try it. Question. So now I've cursed the maze along with Curse the Unknown. No reason for us to go into the store. And again, I'm not going to go into the item room here. I just need to remember, I have to remind myself to go drop the trinket inside of the item room. I have so many times where I'm like, oh, we're going to go unlock so-and-so. And then, like, I don't remember to drop a trinket in there. I think that's one of those things that, like, I feel repentance. Just make a key spawn in there. Like, don't make us lose an entire run all because we forgot to do something and drop it in the item room. I feel that's a little bit silly, but that's just me. The Wheel of Fortune, get a mini charge there for our Book of Revelations. Now, because we're looking for planetariums, that means that we're going to have to essentially full clear from here on out. Our chance is not good right now. Like, our planetarium chance is still, I think, a 2% right now. Actually, you know what? I do want Liberty Cap, so I am going to go into this item room just because Liberty Cap could potentially help us out quite a bit. And I'm gonna drop in here. We get Mongo Baby. That's Mongo Baby's good enough. Even though Mongo Baby was nerfed during Repentance's release, what can you do? Blue map. 1 cent would be nice. No. See if we can get 1 penny here from the fires. There we go. Lucky penny at that. We'll take that all day. Go get the blue map, which is going to show us where the secret rooms are and super secret rooms are. Unfortunately, we curse the lost. We just don't know. But, assuming that we actually get a curse-free floor on the next floor, then, yeah. I don't believe that they've done anything to Liberty Cap. I think it still gives you the compass effect. Again, I could be wrong about that. It'd be famine. Of course, we're going to be seeing a horseman quite regularly on every other floor because of the fact we're using the Book of Revelations, which means that we're going to spawn one. And, back in Afterbirth Plus, of course, we always wanted to see orbitals because orbitals were just as good as tiers. And so, in fact, most of the time, even better than tiers. But for the changes to repentance and orbitals are really not even, I'm just going to be honest, they're not even really worth using anymore. Okay, so there's the secret rooms and the super secret room. We only have one key. I don't necessarily want to use it on a golden chest inside of a challenge room. Although the golden chest pool has changed quite a bit. If we get another key, then I'll open up that chest. Let's put it that way. There's our key. Okay. I can use our only bomb. Again, that rule still pretty much applies. If don't use your only bomb on any level unless you are for sure knowing that you do not need it for anything else. Okay? Don't use your only bomb unless if you know you don't need it. Because there's going to be many, many times where you're like, oh, hey, I want to do this, I want to do that. And then it's like, oh, wait, I don't have a bomb anymore. Or sometimes you see like a rock that's holding like two different bombs. And for one bomb, you could have gotten two, you know. But one bomb, you could have gotten an extra one. You know what I mean. Okay, so we actually gain resources in there, which is kind of nice. I don't know how that missed us, but Judas was, he was looking there. He was standing there as dumbfounded as I was. For this run here, we don't have to go beat the beast. We just have to unlock the tainted juice. Now, that being said, of course, we still want to try to win. I mean, we're going to try to win here, but you know, it doesn't matter if we die to the beast as long as we unlock the tainted Judas character. I think. I don't know if that's for sure. It wouldn't surprise me if we didn't get credit if we ended up dying. But I'm pretty sure as soon as you touch the tainted character, it unlocks. I've not found our item room yet. Not that it really matters, because obviously we're not going to go in there. But we do need to do 100% full clears until we find a planetarium, if we find one. Because they can spawn on you even naturally, as I just showed on stream the other day, with a 1% chance. That blew my mind. I was like, no way. And we got Pluto, which, I mean, Pluto was okay, you know. It's not the greatest. It did give you a huge tears up, which was nice. We're going to go all the way back over here. Still have one bomb, so we can go into the secret room if we really needed to. There's no reason for us to go into the curse room, really. And we only have a 38% chance for a deal with the angels right now, because we're Judas, I think, or something. I don't know. I haven't figured out what figures out which is what and what's this in repentance yet, in terms of the angel deals versus the devil deals. So we get justice here, which is going to be kind of nice. Kind of a beaut. Tarot cloth is going to let us use the tarot cards twice. We get double the payout, which is very good. Now we've upped our rating to a 40.6 in hopes of us getting an angel deal. I wouldn't mind having like Holy Mantle. I mean, any of the offensive angel items would be good as well. Sacred Heart, Godhead, etc. Now, on the subject of skipping item rooms here, again, during the ascent, we will be able to come back through the catacombs, assuming we have a key, and go get that item that we're skipping in here. I was going to go check out the super secret room. Just got the magic mush effect. That's probably going to be the only time you're ever going to see the magic mush effect on this channel again, I would say. Unfortunately, magic mush was not removed from the game, obviously, but might as well have been. I think magic mush only drops from mushroom spawns now, I think. All I know is that you can't get magic mush in item rooms, you can't get them from bosses anymore. An eternal heart, we get a ball of bandages. We don't get the angel deal, but we're gonna head on down. A 76.3% chance for a deal with the angels. Bomb. Okay, so this is probably the last item room I'm willing to skip. I don't like to skip more than one. I don't like to skip more than two. Like a 40% chance for a planetarium, I think, is fair. I mean, literally, it's not fair, but like, you know what I mean. Like, I don't want to skip too many items. Especially with us going to Dogma, like we're going to need all the items we can get. Assuming we actually live through there. Now, of course, we have so much HP right now that it's not going to really matter for us skipping a whole lot of item rooms. But, you know, I think going to the Depths 1 or Necropolis 1, if you're doing a Dogma run and you're still looking for planetariums, I think that's the appropriate amount for me anyway. I don't want to, like, just skip, like, five item rooms. And, yes, you get a guaranteed planetarium, but at what cost? You could have gotten something that could have really helped you, made your life a whole lot easier. Take out the champion first over here. I'm going to go in the curse room because we have plenty of HP. Soul heart for our troubles. And range up. I'm coming away losing a soul heart. And there's a dice room in here. It's a one room. I don't think this re-rolls your active item. We got 9-volt caffeine pill. We kept the blue map, but we got BOGO bombs, glass shard. All we really lost was the orbital and the tears up from the divorce papers. That's about it. We gained the 9 volt, which, you know, could help, I guess. I'm happy that we got some movement speed. So yeah, I'd say that was a side grade. You know, it wasn't really spectacular. We didn't lose anything super important, but we also didn't gain anything super important either. I'm happy. I'd rather have a little bit more movement speed than tears rate. I know. Pick your jaws up off the ground. What the heck is that? Lighter. Watch the world burn. Or do we just fire? We fire the occasional fire or something like that? Oh. Okay. It lights a mob on fire. Interesting. So it will light one enemy on fire in the next room. That's pretty awesome. I still think Liberty Cap is better because we have the treasure map. Although we haven't seen Liberty Cap proc yet, which makes me think that they may have changed it. We'll test our theory on the next floor. Agreed. Currently bleeding right now thanks to Shattered Glass. Glass Shard, I should say. And we're just gonna, I guess, get our butt kicked by greed. So we're gonna keep bleeding until we heal, I believe. We're about to take damage again. And I don't know how we're supposed to heal when we have to get a soul heart, I guess. No, let's stop getting destroyed by, like, everything. This is actually pretty good in terms of, like, tiers. But it's not worth, like, losing HP for, though. The blue cap, this should heal us here. There we go. Okay, we get Lazarus' Rags and the Holy Poop. I guess we'll give ourselves a respawn, but it doesn't really help us because we don't need... Or do we need the Lazarus unlock? I think we do, actually. I think we do. Yeah, we have Liberty Cap. Yeah, we're good. Okay, let's see if we can get Liberty Cap to proc. If it doesn't do it by, like, say, 15 minutes and 15 seconds, then I'm going to assume they changed it. Then I'll look it up on Platinum Go. So we have a decent shot at us getting a planetarium on this floor. I have a feeling they changed it. Funny how the time is stopping every time we're going through the loading screen. Okay. I'm going to assume that they changed it. Let me go check Platinum Guide real quick. Two shakes and a wiggle. Oh, hell, this trinket gives a random mushroom effect. Yeah, so they've removed the compass effect from it. Okay. That's unfortunate because that was one of the classic things that you wanted for... You wanted for Liberty Cap 4. Now we do spawn a planetarium here, so let's see if it was worth it. Can we get a good planetarium item? I mean, they're all good supposedly, but can we get, like, you know, one of the exciting ones? I'm not familiar with this one. Saturnus? Whoa. Okay. That is interesting. I wonder if the tears would give you... Would I wonder if they would, like, keep their effect if we had, like, Death's Touch or something. I mean, that's pretty cool, but, like, to me, it doesn't seem, like, all that great unless the tears are, like, shooting and stuff, because, like, as soon as they make contact with something, then that's it. No. Oh, wait a second. It's gathering tears? just got hit. So now glass shard's gonna go crazy. Enemy tiers were rotating around us. Okay. More Babylon. Little Brimmy, you might as well come too. Huh. So maybe if we move the correct way. Maybe if we move the correct way, the enemy tiers will possibly join the orbit or something. Still bleeding. And super greed. I don't know how that I was specifically watching Super Greed's tears there, and it didn't look like they did anything, so. You know what? Forget it. I'm not even gonna try to get those blue fires. Yeah, we're still taking damage from Shard of Glass. Apparently giving yourself a soul heart is not the same as healing. The Shard of Glass is actually like, I think personally it's not worth the Shard of Glass. So it took a red heart now from our bone heart. So I guess if we just get a red heart and heal, health. Get a health up, but that's not healing. Heck one, now we have Horde Babylon activated. We maintain our tiers. Getting solid damage there on war. We'll head on down. I'm going to see what Saturnus does. It has a chance to absorb enemy tiers and then add them to the orbiting tiers. They can be used to damage enemies. Tiers orbit for 13 seconds before dropping off. Gives you an aura. Okay, so it's not what I would say is spectacular in terms of planetarium items. I wonder what some of the really good. I keep hearing from people that plant that they're totally worth it. So why is our? Oh, it's because that's right. Fine. I was trying to figure out why our laser all of a sudden was blue, and then I remembered it's because we lost the Horde Babylon effect. I mean, I guess it is nice, like, when if all tiers had it can join your orbit, but the fact that it only is every now and then is a little bit it's unreliable at best, I would say. We need to hold on to a bomb, at least one bomb here, so we can get a tinted skull. I mean, so far I have not seen any planetarium items that I've been like, oh man, that's like game changing. No. Maybe I'm just getting unlucky. I also haven't been going for planetariums all that much in my run so far, so you know, it's possible that look, I didn't actually see the skull. It's because it's not in there. I don't know. Yeah, let me know in the comments which planetarium item you think is the best. I would love to know, because I have not seen it yet, I don't think. Leaving the red hearts just in case we take damage, obviously. Want to be able to heal ourselves so we don't bleed out and stuff. I mean, the little tear effects that you get with the Shard of Glass whenever you're bleeding are nice. They definitely help out in terms of the DPS overall, but not worth the HP. My opinion, anyway. Yeah, there's, again, so many ways for you to lose HP in Repentance. One thing I don't want to do is lose even more HP, especially if it's on a passive item. time. Sound money has not been a problem at all in this run. The D1. I'd rather have the HP here, to be honest. $0.74 now. Let's go check out the shop. It's gonna be restock, which I mean, restock is, it definitely has been, it's been nerfed pretty badly. Take fanny pack. What happens now with restock is that everything that it restocks with goes up in price by one, or in this case by six. Cross card, two of clubs, doubles our bombs, Empress, Hangman, World card. Get Mama Mega as well. I think we'll hold on to the. Onto the stars card. We haven't found the tinted skull yet, but with the stars card, we don't have to worry about it. I'm laughing because of the length of distance that tier had to travel in order to hit us was incredible. Troll Bomb was spawned by Fanny Pack. And we have no way to heal currently. Yep. The Judas's freaking Shadow and Guppy's Tail. Which, I mean, we can take both of these here. Polar Invincibility does not exist in Repentance, unfortunately. Well, that's not true. It exists, but it doesn't exist if you're going for Dogma. Because you have to give up... You have to relinquish the ownership of the Polaroid. And honestly, we'll take the World card. Yeah, let's take the World card. You can bomb one more time for a little bit of extra money. I know that's counterintuitive to what we just got done doing, but hey, I'd rather do that and get almost a full rack of hearts than not. We never saw the Tinted Skull. It's probably in one of the rooms that we haven't been in. Or I may have just missed it. I don't think that the Tinted Skull can actually appear inside of a secret room. Just for S's and G's, I just want to see if it's over here. It is. Yeah, so it was in the last room that we didn't go to. Cool card, of course. We get Lazarus's Rags and also Juice's Shadow, but we're not going to need any of them. But I think that we're well off right now. All right. Now comes the second half of the run, and definitely the stronger of the two. I say stronger of the two, but the more dangerous of the two. Paths here. I just realized that the blue beam is from God's Flesh proccing off of Liberty Cap, not anything else. Not Horror Babylon. The Baby Bender would be quite the showstopper right now if we could get it. One bomb for two and a chest, I think, is a pretty good deal. And we can go inside the regular secret room as well. Or Moolah. Oh, it's a 0% chance. Never mind. Okay, so I use Saturnus to take out that one that was charging us. This doesn't... Well, I guess this could technically be the boss, I suppose. Thank you, little Brimmy. course, with us having Tech One, we have unlimited. We've got unlimited range. Might as well go check out the super secret room over here. Plenty of bombs. Yeah, this is not an overly powerful run that we've got going here, but, you know, it's right now it's working, and let's head on up to the ascent.
Spent it. It's gone. Just get over it.
And let's get her done. All right, here's the mausoleum.
How can you have spent our savings?
Very happy you have Pinky Eye. Poison is actually pretty darn good in Repentance. And we should have a cracked key coming up soon. Yeah. I don't remember what floor we left it in. I think we left it on floor 2, actually. So basement 2 is when we most likely will see our cracked key. And now is when we can sort of cash in on those items that we didn't take earlier in the run. Full charge on the Book of Revelations, which is fantastic. And okay, there we go. I think it'd be cool if Saturnus could pick up. I think it'd be cool if it could pick up enemies in your orbit as well. You can kind of fling them at people. I think that'd be neat. Oh yeah. I think we're done taking pills here. I've seen enough.
Self-destructive and disturbed, just like his father. Look at who he has to look up to. If you're drunk to get over here, shut up! Shut up! Just keep pushing me like this. I'm leaving. Good. Leave! We'll be fine without you. Abandon us. Abandon yourself.
It's nice combining the Tech One shot with a little Brimmy as well. Again, unlimited range, just huge potential and huge safety. And now we're going to get to the rooms that we have not been in yet. Oh, this is a long basement here. Or this is a long caves too, I should say. Endless Nameless. I'd rather have the poison. Hourglass would be pretty good if we had some way to recharge it. It is on a one room cooldown thanks to the 9-volt, but that doesn't help as much against Dogma. I'm not sure if Ed and Vin have fixed Bob's brain yet. I've been hearing from a lot of people who've been taking Bob's brain that the trigger still is kind of unreliable. There's a reason why I still don't think it's worth taking. There are some items in Repentance that I'm like, yeah, I still don't know. Like Isaac's Heart is definitely one of those. Okay, so basement 2, this should be where our cracked key is. Should be being the key word. I think this is the one where we dropped the missing page number 2. Or not the missing page, the blank poster or whatever. I don't know why that one room is open like that. Unless that's the item room. Yeah, that is the item room. Oh god, I grabbed the big tier. Yeah, there it is. Alright, so we have the cracked key, and this is going to unlock the Tainted Judas. The Bone Heart. Not going to take the Bone Heart. That would be nice if the tiers... One thing that would be really cool is if the tiers from Saturnus actually persisted. That would be really awesome. I don't know if that's asking for too much, but I think that would be really cool. I like the idea for the item for sure. All right, here we are in basement one. Tan, I don't think it's going to be that useful anymore. Oh, God. So it looks like it might be a bit random for when what determines, like... All right, fine, Demon Baby. It seems like it might be a little bit random as far as what determines when a tier gets picked up by Saturnus and when it doesn't. I mean, we can just keep doing this all day, brother. There you go, get the nice little poison off with Pinky Eye. Beautiful. There you go, get the instant destruction of the mobs in here. We get Dad's Lost Coin, which is going to give us a luck upgrade and a range upgrade, which obviously for Tech 1 is not going to matter. Ooh, this could be pretty dope here if we can get a couple Soul Hearts. I wouldn't mind that. Baby Bender would also not be too bad. There's one. Hey, wow, that worked out beautifully. The judgment there too. I don't think we need to play the judgment. And away we go. Alright, now I realize that we could have just simply healed in the bed here, but you know, where's the fun in that? There's Judas. We got the achievement unlocked, the Deceiver. Mom's Eye would definitely take. And here we go. Again, we've already beaten Dogma with Judas, but I wouldn't mind taking another win. See if we can do it with kind of a not great build for this, to be honest. I'll be surprised. We got full HP. There's really no excuse for us not to. It's just you know, we're not just incredibly overpowered. Almost got hit by the energy there. Oh, apparently touching the TV does contact damage. I did not know that. Oh, we actually grabbed the tears from Dogma. There we go. Wonder if we can grab you. Oh yeah, look at that. We can grab the feathers. Oh, Remember, we do get a 3-heart heal as well whenever we are about to fight the beast. Agma was so frozen, we froze him, and he still got the attack off, the little beam. Now, this is an attack that I honestly don't know how you're supposed to dodge without having, like, supreme movement speed. I guess you can kind of treat it like Mother in a way. We got the poison, demon baby, doing it up. All right, down goes Dogma. I'm going to go ahead and skip this cutscene, even though it is cool. We gotta crank the tunes a little bit. I love the ending theme for the beast fight. Here we go. Saturnus for this fight might actually be pretty darn awesome. As you're seeing, we're actually picking up a lot of the projectiles here. We can use them against Famine. There we go. Not sure what hit us there, but. Here comes Pestilence. Yo, I would try to catch that tier, but I'm afraid to. I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing right now. Literally don't know what I'm supposed to be doing right now. Okay. Somehow we didn't get hit by that. I don't know how. Dropping some bombs on Pestilence here. Here comes War. Instantly froze him. That's good. They're just little tears. Now keep your eye after we beat War, keep your eye on Death in the background. It's a little funny thing that Death does when War dies. Our damage. There we go. Keep your eye on Death. I don't know if you saw that, but definitely rewind it. You get a clear shot of Death face palming and shaking his head in disappointment at his brother. I spawned right on top of this, huh? Definitely want to get out of the death fight here quickly. There we go. All right, it's gonna be pretty iffy, I would say, on this fight here. Bombs here just to help supplement. I mean, we got so many bombs here. I Oh, look at that. Saturnus is actually picking up some of the fires. That helps out a lot. Although freezing it didn't help. Hey, look, I remember that that hit you. Never actually gotten to this phase on this side of the board here. We're completely out of bombs. Maybe I wish he had slightly more range. Alright, now we're in phase two. Demon Baby is close enough to... Well, he was close enough to fire. There we go. Damage is so bad. Demon Baby. Do it. He's done it. Look at that. Well, we didn't expect that one, did we? So we get the B-side Judas done. Apologies for skipping that, but yeah, that fight took forever. So there he is. Shadow Eater Dark Arts, whatever that is. So thank you for watching, everyone. Again, thank you to those of you who took the extra effort, and also everyone who takes the extra effort and liking the videos and leaving a comment down below. It's the best way to support my channel. This month is already proving to be one of the biggest and on pace to be the biggest month of all time for our channel, and it's all thanks to you all in the mosh pit. So thank you very much. Go check out the other videos this week. Go watch the Thusmas VOD coming up later on today in the 2 o'clock spot. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Xander Hayes, Anthony Agresta, Mrose2096, Aaron York, Aragos, David Whitfield, and Sebastian Iorga. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.